everybody should be really concerned about what we're seeing globally from our data set.
NASA's latest climate report confirms 2023 was the hottest year on record, and July of 2023 was the hottest month ever recorded since the 1800s.
We are truly in a climate-changed impact world.
Ivona Sedinich is a NASA oceanographer who uses satellite imagery to study our oceans. She says data from NASA and NOAA shows that 2023 continues a trend of the last 10 years being the hottest on record.
This graph from NASA shows our seasonal cycle of temperature changes over time. And while changes in a couple degrees Fahrenheit might not seem like a lot, scientists say it is more than enough to affect our daily lives here on Earth.
More extreme events, more rainfall, more aggressive precipitation. But on the other side, we see droughts and heat waves and everything as impact on the local ecosystem. It changes the way that they have to behave and ultimately impacts our economy and our livelihood.
So what does that look like? Well, in some cases, it looks like this. Summertime beach closures, thanks to high levels of bacteria or algae in the water.
And last summer, we had this unprecedented red tide of the type of phytoplankton that never bloomed there before. And there might have been a response to really heavy precipitation that was hitting New England area during the early in the summer.
NASA and NOAA are introducing a new satellite in the next month called PACE to better understand how rising global temperatures affect our waters and atmosphere. Sedinich is going to put her skills to work to study our oceans, atmosphere, and air quality, including places like the Gulf of Maine.
This information can be useful to understand where to put aquaculture site, where to fish, what kind of fishing yield are we, you know, expecting, what kind of water is it going to be on our beaches, can we swim? But it's going to be also able to answer day-to-day questions of everybody who lives in Gulf of Maine and region of New England.